I think I'm growing old. I am restless. People say that I'm fastidious. Hi, I'm Arsenic Album.
Hello friends, welcome to Studio Homeopathy. Today I'm going to talk to you about one of the most frequently used medicinal preparations in homeopathy, the remedy Arsenic Album, commonly spoken as Arsalb. It is one of the remedies taught in the first year of homeopathic education, but useful in all our lives in practically all clinical conditions ranging from a common cold to cancer. Let's understand this multifaceted drug. Arsenic Alb, made from arsenic trioxide. Brewer is none other than Dr. Samuel Hahnemann himself. The sphere of action is the alimentary canal, the respiratory and the skin and the mucosa. Now, if you remember, in your forensic medicine and toxicology studies in the second year, you must have studied about the toxicity of this drug. Arsenic toxicity causes rice watery stools, which are very, very similar to cholera, leaving behind severe prostrations. So, in your clinical practice, if you see a clinical symptomatic manifestation which could be seen and arsenic alb could be prescribed, I think you can get wonderful results, especially when I talk about rice watery stools or diarrhea with prostration. So, basically, the complaints of arsenic alb are from alcoholism, especially beer, ice cream, ice water, melons, fruit juices. Most importantly is also the dissecting or the septic wounds, tobacco, no doubt, and decayed food or animal matter. As you know, as in one of my presentations also where I have presented that, you know, when people eat food or meat which is actually decayed and, you know, which is cooked, and, you know, so patients can come with these symptoms of very similar to diarrhea, and arsenic can be one of the major remedies to be prescribed. Now, to prescribe arsenic, the three very, very important clinical features which are required for its prescription are: number one, mentally, the patient is very, very restless. Number two, physically, the patient has a lot of burning sensation, which is especially on the skin. The patient describes, which is very well classically described in Kent, like burns like fire, as if hot coals were applied to parts. And lastly, the third, unquenchable thirst for cold water. Now, unless and until you don't have these three trios, you know, it becomes very difficult to prescribe arsenic. Now, coming up to the mental or the psychological aspects of this drug. Now, usually suited to a personality who feels he's old and weak. He's not actually old, but he feels he's old. And because of his condition, he feels people are actually taking a lot of advantage of him. Now, with that, he becomes very suspicious, he doesn't believe in taking medicines, and he doesn't have actually faith in it. So, you know, you will come across patients in your clinic who actually take the medicine, but when they go back home, they don't take it, you know, because they're suspicious about it. On the other hand, with the mental anguish is also seen physically as a lot of restlessness. So one side there is restlessness, but on the other side, the patient is very physically too weak to move. Now, along with this restlessness as well as suspiciousness comes a very important feature in arsenic, is the fear of death and being alone. Now, lastly, all of this has to be covered with fastidiousness, because the patient is so particular in everything he does. Dr. Shankaran very beautifully says that the patient is conscientious, and because of which it is leading him to being fastidious. Coming up to head symptoms in particulars, headache is usually on the left side, which is radiating to the eye and the ears, with vertigo, which is aggravated on lying down. Now, I remember in our good old days, you know, in our education, you know, where our teachers would tell us that the patient feels much better when he puts cold applications on the head. So, patients with cold applications on the head, and as soon as he removes it, you know, he feels worse. So teachers would tell us that, remember that the patient is actually putting his head into a refrigerator and the body in an oven. So this is a very contradictory symptom, you know, which you see in arsenic, and especially in the head symptoms. Now, coming up to the other systems, that is respiratory affections, I think the most important symptom that you see is thin excoriating discharge, which comes from the nose. And post that, the child or the patient develops thin excoriating discharge. And post that, the nose feels stooped up with this fluent coryza. Sneezing is there, but completely without any relief. Now, along with this, comes this cold actually travels into the lower respiratory tract. So in lower respiratory tract, people with asthma coming with wheezing, especially shortness of breath, and which are aggravated when they're lying down, especially in the night, they feel there is a fear of suffocation which comes up in midnight. Arsenic is the drug to be remembered for this kind of clinical symptom. Lastly, beautifully described in Kent as sensation of vapors of sulfur in the larynx. You know, nowadays you may not see sulfur vapors, but you know, something like a smoke is being there and you know, it's going into the larynx. So, you know, the choking up feeling, which is very commonly seen in arsenic album. Coming up to the gastric symptoms, the keynote of arsenic, as you know, is burning. So there is burning in the entire alimentary system. All of this post overconsumption of vegetable diets, watery fruits, vinegar, ice cream, abuse of ice water, tobacco, beer, and lastly, strong cheese. You know, when I talk about ice water, tobacco, beer, you know, it's also very commonly seen in European or Australian countries, you know, where there is a lot of abuse of ice creams and ice water. And post that, patients can actually develop symptoms which are very similar to arsenic. Burning in the epigastrium should again be very remembered in a patient of arsenic. Now, with this, there is a burning thirst for ice cold water. The patient keeps drinking small quantities of water at very short intervals. But something which differentiates arsenic from the other remedies is the thirst is absolutely unquenchable. Burning in the abdomen is a very typical amelioration, which is ameliorated by sweet milk, craves acids and coffee. Now, coming up to the stools, in arsenic, the stools are small, offensive, and the diarrhea, which is aggravated at midnight but with complete prostration. Please remember, arsenic comes with a complete prostration. In piles, bleeding and burning is again better application of heat. In one of our clinical seminars, I remember one of the legends in homeopathy, Dr. Vadia, used to actually give arsenic alpha for only bleeding piles and wonders it works. Few drops of arsenic on tongue and actually it can stop bleeding. Coming up to urinary complaints, they have a very peculiar aggravation modality, fissures, making voiding urine difficult. So this includes the symptoms of the GI tract and the urinary symptom. Coming up to the skin, the major sphere of action. The skin of an arsenic is very dry, it's rough, it's scaly. Now, most importantly, the skin has ulcers, you know, which are more gangrenous or have an offensive discharge. Poisonous wounds turning into gangrene, worse cold and scratching, and better warm applications. In diabetic foot, please, doctors, it's very important to remember that, you know, you get these kind of ulcers with offensive discharge. Arsenic can be one of the leading remedies to be prescribed in such clinical conditions. Along with this comes the fever. So, as I told you, there is gangrene, so of course there is going to be septic as well as there is intermittent fevers. Patient has a lot of burning sensation. Externally, the patient is cold, but internally there is a burning heat. Yet, the patient is very, very sensitive to cold, but wants to still go out in open air, something very similar like pulsatilla. But along with this, there is marked exhaustion, there is restlessness, and please don't forget, it has to have the thirst symptoms, which is the main guiding symptom for this remedy. Now, sometimes in pathological conditions, like, you know, you may have paucity of symptoms. So you can, of course, prescribe arsenic, especially coming up in malignant conditions, septicemic conditions. I have personally used this medicine in post-chemotherapy protocols. You know, in post-chemotherapy, when the patient takes, there is a lot of burning, there is a lot of diarrhea, patient is very, very restless. And in a small clinical study, and we saw arsenic working wonders. And in boric, it's written, most importantly, it maintains a system under the stress of malignancy, regardless of location. Great prostration with rapid sinking of vital forces. So you can imagine the amount of the sphere of action this drug has. Lastly, hydrothorax, a pleural effusion, and patients who develop metastasis, so hepatosplenomegaly, again, you can think about arsenic alb. Now, when it comes to the relationship and miasm, arsenic alb fits very well into three miasms. So there is a coryza which the patient has, but on the other hand, the patient can also develop gangrenes. And on the other hand, patient is also developing something like cancer. So it fits into all three miasms and all acute conditions in allergic manifestations, and, you know, and lastly, the destructive tendency. So it comes from psora, it can also go to psychotic, and lastly, of course, the syphilitic. So it's a multi-miasmatic drug. Complementary, carbovege, phosphorus, and lastly, please remember, whenever septic fever, spirogen is one of the leading medicines you should prescribe. So I hope you learned the arsenic drug picture in a short presentation of mine. If there is anything you would like to share or write to us, please, you know, there is a link below. You can, of course, write to us. And so take care, live, learn, and love homeopathy.